पुनीत राजपूत. पुनीत इज द सीनियर डायरेक्टर एचआर फॉर इंडिया एंड साउथ एशिया एट थर्मो फिशर साइंटिफिक. शी हैज ओवर 15 ईयर्स ऑफ रिच एक्सपीरियंस इन फार्मा, टेलीकॉम, लाइफ साइंसेज एंड कंसल्टिंग इंडस्ट्री इन मल्टी कल्चरल एनवायरमेंट. पुनीत इज एन एलुमनस ऑफ मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी एंड सेंट जेवियर कॉलेज. एंड पुनीत, अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट आई थिंक टॉपिक दैट इज कमिंग फॉर यू. दिस पैंडमिक इजंट जस्ट अ फिजिकल हेल्थ इश्यू, इट्स ऑल्सो सीरियस मेंटल हेल्थ इश्यू. And this will require special attention from all of us. Mental wellness is of substantial importance in the workplace. Many organizations don't have adequate programs or culture in place to address mental health concern during the pandemic. Can you please share some insights on this important issue? Over to you, please.
Sure. Thank you so much, Gaurav, and thank you to all the esteemed panel. I think very interesting insights, and Gautam definitely will take back the advice on, you know, deducting from CDC and making a health check mandatory. Obviously, you know, mental health, I think, is an important topic generally, but more so in the COVID era, it has come up in forefront. I just wanted to sketch a little bit of a background and then probably talk about, you know, more in terms of what are some of the initiatives that organizations can take. So COVID obviously has been like a black swan event, impacting thousands of people and lives across the globe. It has impacted people on multiple fronts. So first is obviously the physical health of self and the family members, the loved ones. The second is the emotional well-being. So there's a fear of getting infected, there's anxiety, there's loss of life. And then there is grief, right? The third is obviously the financial impact. So again, anxiety related to job security, loss of job, reduced income, layoffs. Finally, the entire thing comes together to talk about what we call as the self-image and self-confidence. So it's been no you know, surprise that if you look at the data and the studies that have been published at multiple national as well as international forums, the surge in the mental health problems has seen a record high in the last couple of months. And therefore, you know, we look at, you know, what has the government been doing or what are the initiatives organizations have been taking to help us through this particular pandemic. There's obviously a lot of offerings that have come into fore. So you have things like doctor online consultations or traditionally what were known as the employee assistance programs, which are specialized counselors. And, you know, those kind of tie-ups, or you have the wellness, you know, sessions, which look at the total, not just the physical, but the mental well-being as well, alternative therapies, all of that put together. But, you know, at the end of the day, it is, as an individual, it is about the place that I work, the people I interact with. Gaurav, my firm belief is that, you know, mental health as a topic is still not very openly spoken about in our culture. You know, I'll ask everybody a question. When was the last time you ever said to your manager or anybody of your peer that I'm going to take leave because I'm depressed? I don't think we've heard about those things, right? It's such a big mental block that you can't talk about mental health to anyone. So that's the first thing. As our colleagues get back to our workplace, or as we have, you know, people more and more getting engaged with regular life, we're going to have what we call as the counselors in chief, which means that all our leaders and all our managers will have to have this heightened sense of sensitivity and empathy to know when is the right time to refer somebody to an employee assistance program, or even, you know, something like a dysfunctional meeting, which has led to a lot of grief. Or it could also be some people who are coming back to work who have suffered a personal loss. And then finally, you also have, you know, something as simple as thank you notes, or, you know, going an extra mile to show that appreciation, sensitivity, which otherwise did not exist, or it existed in more of appreciation platforms, but this is going beyond to kind of have that kind of an emotional connect, which is more important now. As leaders, I definitely think that we need to walk the talk. So, you know, be open about it, make it real. be vulnerable, talk about your highs and talk about your lows, so that people know that this exists and this is okay to share, and that makes people more comfortable talking about these things, not just in their personal space but also in their work environment, that they are not judged for it. Many organizations are also kind of looking at relabeling their sick leaves as wellness leaves, because you wouldn't say that I'm depressed and I'm applying for sick leave, right? So they are looking at that, but this is just the first step in that direction. I think a lot is going to happen when we kind of talk about it more openly and lead by example, as I said, because the real stories, real people is what will make the change in this whole domain. There are multiple things, good things that have also happened. So you also have, the technology, as our esteemed panel already spoke about, the technology adoption has never been so fast and so easy. So, you have today kindergarten children who also know how to get onto Google Meets and Zoom to attend their online classes. You have, most of the fine dining things coming in as innovative approaches of exotic cooking at home. So customer experience in itself is changing. The people demands are also changing. So our supply chains are changing. The contactless delivery or safe packaging are new norms, which are forcing organizations to also look at new standard operating procedures. So all of these environmental changes that are happening are taking a big toll on individuals in terms of ability to adapt, ability to cope, the support that individuals require to kind of get onto this new phase and the new normal. So with that associated is also the mental health area. So, how do you really bring about these systems and support to help individuals and help our colleagues adapt to the new normal? The last piece that I do want to talk about is the trust and communication, that the role of these two elements, which is very, very important. So as the pandemic struck and there was an economic crisis, many organizations did have to obviously react and look at business survival. So there has been an impact on loss of jobs or reduced income for many people. Now, as we try to get back get back to normal, a key is going to be how were these things handled at that point of time. But it's not all lost, because if it's not done, then there's still an opportunity to go back and to kind of build those relationships. And I know Mr. Amar Singh spoke about the core values, but along with the core values, I also would believe that there's a lot of importance that one should give to communication. Because it's your actions speak louder than words, but sometimes your words also have to speak louder, which means that, I'll give you an example of Marriott CEO Sorensen. It was all over social media or even in a Fortune article where he himself communicated to each one of their employees on what the situation was, what were they trying to do in the organization. He announced that he himself and the executive board would take a salary cut, which is leading by example. When you communicate, people do trust what you're kind of trying to do. And there is an inherent value in doing that, because that is what fosters long-term employee motivation, morale, loyalty, as organizations are trying to get back. Now, don't have to go far. This our CEO, Mark Casper, also set up a virtual town hall every month, communicating directly to 75,000 employees across the world, exactly specifying where are we, what are we doing, how is it that we can contribute and help live our mission every day. So I think these kind of initiatives do help in kind of communicating where the organization is. It doesn't definitely make things right overnight. But what it does is definitely creates a value for the long term. So that's the other element of trust and communication. And I'm sure the way the trust whole element has worked, management consultancies have never been able to deploy trust so fast in the past, because COVID has made that happen, which is, when lockdown started, people were forced to work from home. And all the theories around work from office or productivity through office spaces was kind of thrown out of the window, and people had to inherently trust that their people would do their best in the given circumstances and look at newer tools of working in remote environments. So the fancy office spaces have really got replaced by agile work from home kind of offices. So these are all the elements that add, you know, to the change that is happening at a rapid pace. And then when you couple that with the fear of the pandemic in itself, creates a lot of issues or a lot of challenges for an individual to cope with physically, mentally, financially. And you know, that's where I would kind of leave my discussion here. Mental health, as I said, is something that requires all of us to lead by example, be vulnerable, share your stories, and make this a part of your conversation with your colleagues in your day-to-day lives.
Thanks a lot. I think, Puneet, this is very insightful. And I would request all those, there are a lot of decision makers on our panel, and there are a lot of decision makers as participants, that at least the taboo that we have, and very rightly pointed out by you, that when a person is taking a leave, if he says that I have depression or I have to go and see a psychiatrist, there are a lot of, I think, social stigma attached to it. So as a senior leaders, I think somehow if we can break that taboo, now it is already happening with the period leaves. If we can similarly have a movement on the mental health, I think that is extremely important. And the way I think Amar had told about in his initial talk about the compassionate capitalism, I think that is very important. Because if you have shown the empathy and compassion in these times, this will go a very long way in having the loyalty of your employees. So thanks a lot, Puneet, for very important points and a very important topic. So now we go on to our next esteemed panelist, Mr. Prashant Krishnan. Prashant is currently the senior director at Medtronic. He is an experienced business and thought leader in the medical device market with a demonstrated history of managing different business units across market segments in India as well as USA. He was earlier working as director with Johnson & Johnson. Prashant is an alumnus of the Wharton School and Xavier Institute of Management. Prashant, in your illustrious career, you have successfully led many organizations through crisis globally. Can you share your key learnings which will help leaders to successfully lead during these uncertain times? And also, can you please elaborate on the impact of this crisis on medtech industry